Okay, I am running.
I have a remote. So.
We didn't even decide how we're going to do this. We're just starting.
Oh, wait, no. Oh, we did? Okay.
Would you have a remote?
Yeah.
$1,500 doesn't come with a remote.
There you go. There's a topic for a YouTube discussion.
A YouTube discussion.
Different budgets.
Oh, my God. I'm doing this wrong. Can you pass me that? I'm good. So these are four different ones.
I'm assuming it's running, so I know what to look. Now.
I don't know how you want to do this.
Well, do we want to work our way up to that one, or work
our
way down?
We're
going to
do our way, like the last.
There we go.
Do we want it as just one big video?
Sure. I just follow your cue.
Should I always one divide, edit it up?
Okay.
I don't edit, I just go with it.
Yep.
If I screw up, I do it over, or I just put it on anyway.
That's it, exactly. Hey, what's up, everybody? Tim's here. I was waiting for you to go.
I was waiting for you to introduce me.
I was going next. I thought you were just going
to introduce the grumpy old man.
Gregory, grumpy old man, is here. And Tim, you're at my house.
Good afternoon, YouTube. I think we're afternoon.
It is afternoon, YouTubers. Hello, hello.
So,
we're at Raymond's for a change to do a hot sauce taste test tasting.
And we're with the two guys that inspired me to do YouTube videos. These are the ones.
All right, so we got five hot sauces. We're going to work our way up to the last dab. So we're going to mix them up, these four. And we'll do a taste test. I've never tried any of these. We'll go with this one. Yes. Habanero hot sauce from hell. World's hottest hot sauce, beyond hot. Which I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
I don't think so.
And I don't do this, so I have to say I think so.
It gives you cooking instructions for scrambled eggs from hell. But that doesn't matter. Made from water, habanero pepper, vinegar, carrots, salt, xanthan gum, garlic, and spices. I mean, I didn't bring a knife.
I'm just reaching for one.
I got knives behind me. So we'll start hot sauce from hell.
I could tell you a story, but my pocket knife in public school in grade 8, where we had all the little critters in jars for us to cut open, and we had a baby shark. And we had to take it outside in the playground and put it on a piece of wood and try and
watery, so shake it,
cut it up.
Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake.
Yeah, while you're doing that, I'll shake these.
Yeah, it sounds watery. All right. I'm going to take the bigger one because I don't do hot sauce.
Right. I'm smart enough to know we should have milk on the table.
Yeah.
But what do I know?
You take what you want.
Take what I got.
Oh my God, fill your spoon, man.
Well, I always do.
I know.
Except for the...
Except for the Blairs.
Blairs.
All right, cheers.
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 Bottoms up.
Here we go.
Yeah, that's
yes, it is.
Habanero.
It's not. It's a little bit of heat.
I've had worse.
There's the hiccups.
Yeah, me too. No hiccups.
No.
Back of the throat.
No, it's habanero. It's the hiccups.
I'm already thinking of recipes like chicken thigh.
Well, right here it has one for scrambled eggs.
That's what we had this morning.
Oh, me too.
I had sriracha on mine.
I had cheese.
Ketchup.
I'm not a fan of sriracha, but I do like the spicier ketchups I've been getting.
Oh.
But I'm not a sriracha
fan. I use so much...
A little bit of sweat going on.
I use so much sriracha that Jim and Lori's homesteading page on Facebook... God, 8-10 years ago started referring to sriracha as troll ketchup. And we used to go to a Viking reenactment And everybody at the Viking reenactment started calling sriracha troll ketchup. And then they moved it from near where I live, Plantagenet, mm-hmm. out to near Eganville. And then there were all kinds of new people start showing up. People from Toronto were coming up. And I was walking by a campsite, looked over, and there's not a single face in the campsite that I recognize. And then somebody yells, "Hey, can you throw me the troll ketchup?" And I went, "What?" So I went over and introduced myself.
So it's not a big burn on this end.
No.
Not at all.
Even for me, who doesn't like
that
stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
That is actually, I think, milder than the sriracha.
And it says, world's hottest hot sauce. No.
It's very it's a small world.
Right?
After all.
So, yeah.
The little guys that lived underneath the store in Toronto there, Fraggle Rock, maybe to them that would be...
That would.
On the little plastic.
I think all these little guys say world's hottest hot sauce.
Maybe that's the name of the company.
Oh, maybe.
Pick the next one.
I mean, that one. Yeah, there we go. This one says, oh my god, Ass Blaster. Ass Blaster hot sauce.
So are you supposed to take that one after the colon cleanser?
Yes, they all work together, just like pecker butts. Pucker butt.
Yes.
Same thing, habanero, pepper, vinegar, 1 million Scoville, capsicum extract, xanthan gum.
Oh, it's got an
carrot,
extract.
Salt, garlic, and spices. I'm already sweating from that one. So, yeah, it's got extract. That's fun. We know how that goes.
Mind you, problems the straight there. Extract that. From England, it wasn't as hot as the Blair's either, so...
Nope. Oh yeah, we already kind of shaked it.
That's right, you can do it again.
Yeah. Here you go. Ass Blaster! The names. I'm gonna hold it. I'm gonna cheers you ahead. Don't get any years in mine. Here we go.
Bottoms up.
That's a little bit hotter.
Yeah.
Definitely not blasting my ass.
It's not a million Scoville by any.
No, definitely not.
I don't like the overlying flavor to it. Not as much as I like that one.
Tastes like ass. Blaster.
It's a little spicy.
Yeah. Both of us are like, yeah.
But it takes a while for me to get there, but the first taste was...
Whew.
No.
I'm definitely sweating, probably because I'm wearing a tube.
Burning on the tip of my tongues now. Tongues?
You have multiple tongues.
The back of my throat.
Back of the throat.
Oh, wait, yeah, a little bit in the tip now. The water helps. But...
There's the habanero hit.
Cups. Don't know.
Oh.
But I like the first one more for its flavor. This one's definitely hotter.
But definitely hotter, tastes like ass.
I'd have to put something else on it to hide that flavor. I wouldn't cook something with that one.
See, I would much rather use ghost peppers than that.
Yeah.
The flavor is much better.
Doing all right there, Emma?
Yeah, it's hot.
I'm training CPR. I promise not to use it right.
Spontaneous combustion. Ghost pepper popcorn. Same company. Hot sauce. I hope so. Someone says danger. Extreme high. Use sparingly. Avoid contact with eyes. Challenge.
So don't read the label that closely.
Well, we've got this one out. You're doing a giveaway for the ghost pepper popcorn stuff, aren't you?
I am. It's in last week's video. And you can check that out. I'm giving 2 weeks for you to enter the contest. Here's a link right here in the info cards. Alright. No sweat. There's ingredients, water, habanero, pepper, vinegar, got some extract, here we go! Xanthan gum, carrot, salt, garlic, and spices.
The xanthan, it sounds like something from Pierce Anthony book.
And again, made with the million Scoville capsicum extract. Am I saying that right?
Yeah, close enough for rock and roll.
Thank God. Oh, man.
You know, the Brits say it one way, the Aussies say it another way, the Americans say it a third way, so.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Cricker.
You'll get what you're saying. It's close enough for rock and roll.
Tomato, tomato, as long as it's in a paste, doesn't matter.
You guys are making this. Oh. My nose is clearing up. How does that just do it? Oh, this one's a bit thicker.
Are we doing this a little too quickly?
Hey, we're doing this very quick compared to normal. We're good. Oh, cheers. Cheers. I hate all of you. What's up?
La Bamba. Don't throw up.
The flavor is a little better than the second one.
Yeah, that one's burning the whole top of my tongue.
Yeah, it spread out more. Yeah.
And my ear is starting to go numb.
I don't like this game.
What?
My ear is starting to go numb.
What?
Doesn't matter, it's the one I can't hear out of anyway.
So I'm deaf in this one and can't hear out of this one. I'm not blaming the sauce, though.
I don't like this game. I'm crying.
But did you see Chad's latest video?
No.
The Buffalo Wild Wings?
Do you need out? Do you want to go roll
well,
the
he
show?
Doesn't like when I puke. So I need to run somewhere real quick.
Just run off with the
I would
there's
puke in this.
Use your hat.
Oh my God.
Once had to do that on the school bus when I was like 8 or 9.
Okay, that one's pretty good.
That's still
decent flavor, decent burn.
It's moving around the tongue now.
Yeah.
Now the lips.
And now the nose is starting to drool. But Chad did the Buffalo Wild Wings challenge.
Okay.
12 wings with their hotter than hell sauce in 6 minutes. Part of the rules is no touching your face at all, no wiping your face, no.
What, you can't pull out a hanky and go,
nope.
Oh man, excuse me. This is too quick.
That's a nice one.
Gotta see if they. Apparently, all of the stores don't run that contest, though. And the nearest one to us is 295 kilometers away. Down, you have to cross at Syracuse.
Syracuse, yeah. Go into Upper
New
York State.
The next town over has one.
On the way to Albany.
Messina, Syracuse, one of them.
Messina.
Cross the Messina at Syracuse has it. Cross the Syracuse
at Messina talk.
Has it. No, Messina is the crossing at Cornwall, right?
Yeah.
So if you cross it at Messina and go to Syracuse for the wings.
Yes. Road trip.
Habanero. Again. Hot sauce from hell, devil's revenge. World's hottest hot sauce.
That label's been used.
Back with the extract. Same vinegar, carrot, salt, garlic, spices. Xanthan gum. Habanero water.
Habanero water?
Hot water, habanero.
So you give habanero water to drink, and when they go to the toilet, you take that water? There was a comma between habanero and water.
Oh, yeah. I read it all backwards, too.
That's right.
My lips are on fire.
They're coming to take me away, haha.
Oh, yes. I have season's tickets.
So is this curing your sniffles for you now?
No, it's just stuff in my nose more. Everything's burning. We'll need a break before that one.
Yeah, we can do that.
I won't be able to. I know that. Here, look at that. Yeah, that's it. I'm wussing out here. I got the tiniest drop. And he just fills his freaking spoon. What's wrong with you guys? Let's do this.
Wow, that is way vinegarier than any of the other three.
Yes.
I find the ones that say world's hottest aren't.
Wow, that's vinegary.
I think I'm still tasting the hot sauce from the one previous. I don't find anything new being added to my palate.
I noticed with these two there was something new to it.
Yes.
And these two are kind of...
the same...
same category.
Yeah, that was. And of these two... the first one, I didn't like the flavor. So whatever it was, that was...
the beige label.
So spontaneous combustion and ass blasters.
Ass blasters.
Yeah, the ass blaster tasted beige.
Yeah. Yeah. That tasted more blue to me. Blue, green, red.
But this guy... but of the four, the first one is the one I would put on a recipe.
None. Because I don't do hot sauce.
You just did hot
sauce. Yeah, it's this guy's fault.
When you come out to my place because I got the hot sauce, then it's my fault.
That's right.
This is not my fault.
This time you came here. These ones were sponsored by my cousin's husband, Patrick. Thank you for buying these
for us. Thank you, Patrick.
Thank you, Patrick.
I appreciate that so much. Well, sort of. A lot of pain, a lot of burning. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Subscribe to these guys. Links in the description. I'm sure.
Same. Yep, same.
whatever they say.
Yeah.
I haven't learned to do that piece yet.
You will.
Yeah.
Eventually. Okay. Don't do stupid stuff.
First you gotta get a real computer.
Yeah.
And a real phone.
Yeah. Don't do stupid stuff.
That's it for now.
Play Thanks safe. And if you don't play safe, don't name it after me.
Oh, I got it. Because you need to get it first.
On, yeah.
And I need to turn on my camera. And address one thing. I ended up not liking it. Yeah, that's good. You're good. I'm good.
Ting tang wallow bing bing.
I'm a ting tang wallow bing bing.
Greg, in your. There we go.
Come on.
Let's take our picture.
Let's take a picture.
Yep. I was going to try and pose differently.
Well, you're in there.
Yo mama. Everybody's recording.
Everybody's recording. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back for a hot sauce taste test. We got Trollforge.
Hi everybody.
And the grumpy old man. Gregory.
Piss off.
Piss off. Get out of here. Alright, so this week, we're doing the Hot Ones Last Dab Redux Double X. Pepper X, chocolate pepper X are the ingredients. And that's all it says, but I'll, there's a list of other stuff like ginger, coriander, cumin, vinegar. I think that's the list. There's more stuff.
11 herbs and spices.
11 herbs and spices. This isn't a restaurant.
Ginger, turmeric, coriander.
What's there?
Cumin, dry mustard, chocolate, pepper X peppers, twice.
Chocolate and
vinegar. Yes, right. Okay, chocolate. Okay. I was reading it backwards from the bottom up, so that's what threw me off. Okay.
So this is the first we feast, hot ones. The last dab. And it's tradition around here that we put a last dab on the last wing. 3.3 million Scoville units. It's very thick.
Wait, McVeigh.
There you go. Good luck.
More of a paste than a sauce.
Yeah. Mm. Means it's bad. Or good.
Now, you've tried this one, right?
Yes.
Is this hotter than the Blair's?
I mean, I wouldn't do this with Blair's, so I know this one. This one's more of a taste. But, I mean, we just did four more hot sauces before this. Yeah, you're going to have to shake it. Mm. Yeah.
Shake your money maker.
Like, I put more of this. Because in the one we did yesterday, we did it twice. Because we didn't feel the first one was enough. All right. 3.3 million Scoville units. Cheers, everyone.
Glockenspiel.
Launch it.
Blah, blah, blah.
It's a launcher?
It's a launcher. Yeah.
I think it was just a particulate to know.
Yeah, I'm not sure I like the texture of that.
Texture. Very grainy, flaky or something. Or there was a big flake.
It takes its time. It'll kick in.
It seeds.
It seeds.
Ah, okay.
But it's not as, like, it says 3.3 million Scoville unit. But Blair's, I was there to drink it by now.
The one side of the tongue is burning, the other one's just starting to. Not really. Really? Not that bad.
That's not as bad. They did this one more of a flavor.
Mm-hmm. It's a nice flavor.
Like, I'm crying.
We're starting to come.
It's building, yeah, 100%. Yeah,
yeah. Tip of the tongue.
Yep. Right at the back of the tongue. There we go. We're just building, kids.
Sucking the breath out of my lungs. Yep.
Back of my tongue is on fire.
It's warm in here.
Same thought.
The drools are starting.
I like that one.
Yeah. I'm not even talking.
I can see that going into a mole. Like a chocolate chili. Cincinnati chili. Mole. Would be good for that.
Total fat, zero.
I don't think this is any hotter than the 1.6 million Scoville extract we had.
This is made with all natural ingredients, so zero sugar, zero sodium. I'm done.
I do feel it in my chest now.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's nice.
It's not, but okay. It's hot. It's not too much. I'm definitely crying. Uh-huh. This is just so beautiful. What a great moment. Snot.
Yes, it's definitely snot happening.
Ceiling.
We'll explain that later.
Just a shout out to First We Feast, Hot Ones, our last Redux. I like it.
Well, if you like it, you can go to heatless.com, get your very own. What does that say?
Something's popped up on your on his monitor. Just gone away.
But is it still recording?
Light flashing, is that any indication?
Yeah, I guess it's still recording. I can't see it at the top of the screen.
It's gone away. It was right in the middle of the screen. It went away.
Either way, we'll see. And if I need to steal from Tim, I'll steal from Tim.
Well, Tim had technical difficulties. He lost
the tail end of the last one.
My remotely operated... It's doing quite well. Thank you very much.
After four false starts on this go.
Well, that's because when it went to sleep, it went on to photo and not video. So that's... I blame the operator.
Take my last step.
Well, I want to thank you two guys for sharing this with me.
No,
I want to thank you for watching.
Thank you.
And as they have taught me, subscribe. I don't know what that part means, but...
Subscribe.
But I don't know what they're saying when they... You know, across the bottom, because there's nothing across the bottom, but you can't fill them.
There you go.
Yeah.
I'll teach you how to do that.
Yeah, yeah. You're going to learn.
I will buy a better computer. The one I have, or we upgrade the one I have. It's there. Make it work better.
The heat's slowly going down now.
Yep.
I was just
pretty quickly going down now.
Yeah.
Still feels like there's a hot piece of coal on the tip of my tongue, but all the other symptoms are reducing.
Well, it's in the name, Redux.
They have several different flavors of the last dab. They got a Carolina Reaper one, they got Scorpion Pepper one.
Scorpion pepper one might be good.
Well, this bottle with shipping and handling cost me $50.
Wait,
that's the kicker.
Wow. That's American or Canadian?
Canadian.
Oh, that's all right. Add another 25% if it was American.
Yeah, well, the American Postal Service gouges for anything going to Canada.
Here, grumpy old man thing. I ordered some beeswax from the States. It got shipped to Chicago and sat in Chicago for 3 friggin' weeks. When they finally turned it over to Canadian Customs, 3 days later it was in my mailbox. Like 3 weeks, I was complaining to the guy I bought it from, like, oh, they said they'll get to it. Get to it, pick up the phone and call them and say, do your friggin' job. There's no excuse for it to sit there for 3 weeks. And this was after the Trump shutdown. So you can't blame it on the Postal Service being shut down. The Canadian Postal System went on strike. I mailed postcards from England and Ireland back in from mid-October to mid-November.
Now
a week ago, two of them arrived.
The one you sent me arrived last week.
Yeah, and my brother right here, just up the street here in Vanier, he got his the same day. It's like, really? About 3 weeks for it to sit in Chicago. Purelator held on to my TV for 6 days in the warehouse in Ottawa. Put it in the friggin' truck. And then, of course, if you follow some of the other videos, the local driver, invariably something will sit in his truck for 3 days as he drives up and down the road looking for my home. Or some other excuse for not delivering it.
And you guys thought you liked my rants. Go check out his channel for his rants. Because that's what it's like.
That's
link in the description.
Grumpy old man. I'm grumpy, and I've been told to take it out on YouTube. So it's helped.
It's the best place.
I'm feeling much better now, and I don't have to self-medicate as much.
You guys are like a therapist.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
Without the exorbitant insurance charges.
Yeah.
That's it. It's free. So, guys, subscribe to each of these guys. Links in the description.
Hi, guys. Subscribe to Raymond and to Grumpy
and
Old Man.
I appreciate them there teaching me the whole process.
Leave your comments below. Do it.
Comments,
do it.
Yeah.
Comments below. Let us know what you want to see.
Sorry?
Down in the doodly-doo.
Down in the doodly-doo. Yeah, do what you do in the doodly-doo.
If you want to send us something, let us know. We'll give you our address. And don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and don't do stupid stuff.
And if you do stupid stuff, name it after them.
Do it.
That's it for now, and thanks for watching.
$50.
Wow. Thanks for sharing it with me.
No problem.
This was fun. We should do this more often.
So are we releasing this as one video? And this is one video? This has got to be its own video.
I think we should do it the same way we've done the others. So that this, today is 6 videos.
But we didn't end and restart.
What?
We didn't end, but like, hey guys, this is another week.
So?
Perfect. I'll just put my clip in my opening first, and then we go.
Yeah. I'll show Greg how to do it at my place. Fermez la caméra, là, s'il vous plaît.
Yeah, I think my memory card was full. Screen lock, swipe. With my diamond.